1 John chapter 3, verse 14. We know that we have passed out of death into life because we love the brothers. He who doesn't love his brother remains in death. In this context, we're talking about spiritual death, not physical death. And we're talking about spiritual life, not physical life. Verse 15, whoever hates his brother is a murderer. And you know that no murderer has eternal life remaining in him. By this we know love, because he laid down his life for us. And we ought to lay down our lives for the brothers. So John speaks a lot about loving the brothers, even to the point of laying down your life for the brothers. But the question is, who are the brothers? Brothers in this context is synonymous with neighbors. This is not talking about just the members of your church, just the members of your social group. In Luke chapter 10, verse 27, Jesus told a man that he should love his neighbor as himself. But the man wanted to justify himself and said, "Who is my neighbor?" Now, in this context, we can say, "Who is my brother? Who is the brother whom I should love?" So let's read this parable. And every time it says neighbor, let's replace it with brother. Jesus answered, "A certain man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho, and he fell among the robbers, who both stripped him and beat him and departed, leaving him half dead. By chance, a certain priest was going down that way. When he saw him, he passed by on the other side. In the same way, a Levite also, when he came to the place and saw him, passed by on the other side. But a certain Samaritan," keep in mind, Samaritans were looked down upon in this culture, "but a certain Samaritan, as he traveled, came where he was. When he saw him, he was moved with compassion, came to him and bound up his wounds, pouring on oil and wine." Oil here being like the salve and wine being as the disinfectant. "He set him on his own animal and brought him to an inn and took care of him. On the next day when he departed, he took out 2 denarii and gave them to the host and said to him, 'Take care of him. Whatever you spend beyond that, I will repay you when I return.' Now which of these 3 do you think seemed to be a brother to him who fell among the robbers?" He said, "He who showed mercy on him." Jesus said to him, "Go and do likewise." Back to 1 John chapter 3, verse 17. "But whoever has the world's goods and sees his brother in need and closes his heart of compassion against him, how does the love of God remain in him?" In other words, if you see somebody in need and you have the ability to help that person and you don't, how does the love of God abide in you? Verse 18, "My little children, let's not love in word only, neither with the tongue only, but in deed and in truth. And by this we know that we are of the truth and persuade our hearts before him. Because if our heart condemns us, God is greater than our heart and knows all things. Beloved, if our hearts don't condemn us, we have boldness toward God. And whatever we ask, we receive from him because we keep his commandments and do the things that are pleasing in his sight. This is his commandment, that we should believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another even as he commanded." Now, to believe in Jesus means a whole lot more than just a mental ascension, means a whole lot more than just a mental acknowledgement. Remember, Jesus was a rabbi. To believe in a Jewish rabbi means that you do everything that that rabbi says to do. And more than that, that you live by his example. And that speaks a lot when it comes to Jesus. What did Jesus do? How did Jesus live? That is how we should live. Jesus obeyed the commandments of his Father. And notice it says here, when we ask of God, we receive from him because we keep his commandments. If you're praying for something and you have not received that yet, if you have not received an answer from God yet, there could be many reasons. It could be that it's just not God's time yet. But one of these reasons is that it could be that you're just not obeying his commandments as he wants you to. In your prayers, it would be wise for you to ask God to show you your sins. That way you know what you can improve on. That way you know where you're missing it. Once again, we receive from him because We keep his commandments and do the things that are pleasing in his sight. This is his commandment, that we should believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another even as he commanded. He who keeps his commandments remains in him and he in him. Notice there is a condition here. It doesn't say just anybody remains in him. It says he who keeps his commandments remains in him and he in him. By this we know that he remains in us, by the Spirit which he gave us. Never forget, the Holy Spirit is a Holy Spirit. And the more you go by the Holy Spirit, the more you live in holiness.